Hello everyone, and welcome to the last Qantas Learner Done session for this year. Right now you are able to type in the chat, so if you have any questions during the session, please feel free to ask them there, and either I or Henri will get to them. But at the end of the session, we will also enable you to unmute yourself and also to put on your camera. So if you want, then we can also have a little bit of a dialogue at the end of the session. So most of you know us already. We are Qantas, and we are a Dutch fintech company. And what we do is that we help other companies to build new business models and to increase their financial efficiency. And to do so, we have started building public and enterprise blockchain solutions in 2015. And over this period, we have always focused on the intersection between the classic financial world and blockchain technology. Our technology supports different kinds of business models. For example, we support IoT payments, stablecoins, but also cryptocurrency brokerage and custodian services. But for today, we would like to focus on and also present our asset tokenization model. And we will also give you a sneak peek into our Nexus system. So what are asset tokens? Asset tokens are blockchain-based tokens that digitally represent a real tradable asset. And these tokens can both represent financial assets, such as shares or bonds, but also non-financial assets, such as real estate or art. And why is tokenizing interesting? Well, first of all, tokenization enables fractional ownership of alternative assets. This makes it affordable to buy an asset and thereby enables investors to benefit from a wider range of asset choices. This democratizes finance and improves portfolio diversification, while at the same time lowering the barrier to entry for raising capital. Together, all of this greatly increases the liquidity of assets. But also, tokenized assets can be issued and traded much faster and cheaper than in traditional financial systems, while at the same time being more secure. Also, tokenization enables automatic enforcement of compliance, since rules can be programmed into smart contracts. And also, since regulators can monitor real-time and perform on-demand surveys and audits, the cost of compliance can be reduced, while at the same time the confidence in the system increases. To support companies in tokenizing their assets, Qantas has developed Nexus, the gateway to the token economy. Nexus enables companies to create their custom token ecosystem without the need to deal with the technical aspects. Stocks, bonds, but also other financial and non-financial assets can all be tokenized with Nexus and made available for trading on secondary markets. Nexus is built with compliance in mind, and it digitizes multiple real-world assets, but also fiat currencies. Since Nexus digitizes both the asset and the money, it is extremely safe. All transactions are executed atomically, and no transaction ever gets lost. Nexus easily integrates into existing financial systems and requires very little technical skills to operate. The system has been in production for 5 years, and last year we had a near 100% uptime for processing up to 200,000 transactions per day. We've attained both an ISO 27001 and an ISAE 3402 certification, and currently we are working on acquiring an e-money license. With our asset tokenization solution, we enable our business partners to either issue their own asset tokens or to issue asset tokens on behalf of other parties. Let me show you a broad overview of what such a tokenization ecosystem looks like. First, we have the Qantas partner, which is also known as the issuer. The issuer makes the asset tokens available to investors. Of course, we also have the parties that want to tokenize their assets. As mentioned before, this can be company shares, real estate, artwork, but also other types of assets. Then we also have the trustee, which is the party that keeps custody of the asset. And then finally, we have the validator who checks if the tokens in the ecosystem are covered by the real-world asset. And we have a regulator who checks if all of the stakeholders in the ecosystem comply with regulations. So from there, let's go through this ecosystem step by step. Here, we see the account and wallet structure of the issuer. On the bottom is the bank account where the fiat funds are held. In the middle, there's the wallet that holds the digital money. And on top, we can see the wallet that holds the asset tokens. When a company wants to tokenize their assets, they send the physical asset to the trustee, or they let the trustee review the asset. After the physical asset has been verified, the trustee creates the asset tokens and then sends these to the asset token wallet of the issuer. Investors sign up for the service with the issuer. This also means that the issuer is responsible for the KYC and the AML of all of the participants in the ecosystem. After they sign up, investors can fund their digital wallet by sending fiat currency to the bank account of the issuer. Then, when the money is received in the bank account, Nexus will automatically create the same amount of digital money and send this to the wallet of the investors. After they receive the digital money, investors can immediately use them to buy asset tokens. Investors can either buy and sell asset tokens from the issuer, or they can also buy them or sell them to and from other investors. Companies that want to pay out dividends or interest payments can do so easily. They simply send fiat currency to the bank account of the issuer, after which Nexus again will digitize this and then send it to the investors that hold the corresponding asset tokens. So this is a general overview of the asset tokenization model and also what it can do for your business. And I would now like to give the word to my colleague Henri, who will give you a sneak peek into our Nexus system.
Okay, thank you so much, Mark. Can you confirm that my screen is visible?
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay. Hello everybody. As Mark already mentioned, the issuer, and we do have the view of the issuer here on the screen. The issuer is responsible for the KYC and the AML. And Nexus supports issuers with this. So let's have a look at all the customers that are currently in the system. And let's look at customers that are under review or blocked. And if we look at this person, is under review. And apparently there is a match with this person on one of the sanction lists. So we can look at the details. So the name Ali Salem appears, or 50 aliases of this name appear on the OFAC list. And now it's up to the operator to decide if this is a real match or a mismatch, and to block this customer permanently or unblock him. So also I do have an account. So let's search for my account here. And I have a wallet. And what you see here on the right is the balance of my digital wallet. And this wallet is on my notebook. And you can see it here. So I have a stablecoin or a digital money balance, and I do have several assets. So if I want to start trading before that, I first am going to fund my wallet, as Mark has explained. So let me fund my wallet, not too much, but fund for trading. And well, this money arrives on the issuer's bank account. It will be tokenized, so it means minted, and the money will be sent to my digital wallet. And you see it has already arrived on my balance. So and now I'm quite eager to start trading, and since I'm working for Qantas and I already have some Qantas shares, I would like to buy some more. And the nice thing about this blockchain enabled trading is that I can really do very small orders. So let me buy 2 Qantas shares, and I'm prepared to pay 4 euros for them. And let's review. Oh, there's a large price difference. Apparently, it's the price lower, but I'm very keen, so I say okay. I confirm the trade. And what's actually happening now is that the trade is written to the blockchain. So the order book is on the blockchain, and the blockchain will check if a match is possible. Well, it's already done, and well, I do have less money, so it means somewhere a part will be traded. Let's look at the orders, and well, you see here it was partially executed. Yeah, so I tried to trade 2 of them, but apparently there is not enough sell orders in the system, so only 1.3 of the shares was executed. So let me explain in a diagram what actually happened. So we do have traders on the, and they all have their own digital wallet with their own portfolio. I am, let's say, the person on the left side, and I wanted to buy some Qantas shares. And there was another person who offered Qantas shares. We do not know who that was and for how long this was already on the blockchain, but the order was there. And through an atomic swap on the blockchain, in one transaction, the digital wallet from my wallet was sent to the digital wallet of the seller, and in return the assets were transferred from the seller's wallet to my wallet. So this is what we call an atomic swap, and it's in one transaction, and so you never have the first mover disadvantage. And well, apparently you might have seen it. Someone else sold Qantas shares, and now my order is closed. Yeah, so I've now my 2 Qantas shares. Of course, this is a manual trade, but this trade could also be executed by trading bots, and they could well put hundreds of orders on the blockchain. The transaction fees of this trade are paid by the issuer, and as you know, the blockchain trades well are very cheap in on the Stellar system. Let's look. So we have a fee of 0. Lumen with an actual price of 23 cents. So the maximum fee that we pay is about 4 cents, but the actual price will be probably a lot less than that. So let me quickly go through the system and show you some of the other functionality. The system comes with a lot of reports. So over the years, we've generated or created a lot of standard reports, like compliance reports that can be provided to the bank, or if you would like to have an overview of all the token payments, so digital money payments in the so far this month, this report will be created, and once it's ready, we will get notified. The system, the Nexus system, has a role model. There are a total of 13 roles in the system. We have what we call the high risk roles, that are really the roles that can touch the API keys, the digital money, and the digitized assets. We also have the roles that only can view information, like a treasurer or an operator. There's also the special role of the auditor. That means that the issuer can grant his auditor access to the system, and the auditor can, without asking the issuer, generate reports and, well, view and watch what's going on the in the system. The system comes with a lot of documentation. So we do have clients that only use the portal once to set up the system, and furthermore rely on our APIs. And I would say over the years, the APIs are very well tested and are also well documented. So you can start immediately with programming and using the Nexus platform. So, and as Mark already said, we do have customers that perform up to 200,000 transactions per day, and heavily rely on our API. Every customer has three installations. It's what we call the development environment, where our customers can develop their software and use the APIs. We also have what we call the test environment, and the test environment is a copy of the production environment. And this is where our clients test their APIs before they go into production. And the production environment is the, is the customer facing part of our customer's installation. So let me get back to the portal and go with you to through some of the settings. So our report is in the meantime ready. So the token definitions. So far you have seen that I used a stable coin, and you could create your own digital token, your own stable coin. So let's suppose that we want to create a demo token coin. We call it the DTC, and it's backed by the euro. I only have a euro here in the system, but if other currencies were available, I could assign my stablecoin to another currency, and let's say that this is a one DTC is 1 cent. Here are some parameters, and you can switch them on or off. And one of the most interesting ones is maybe what we call the clawback function. And clawback is what it says. It enables the auditor to get access to the assets that an investor holds on his wallet. So why would you do so? Let's say that an investor has all his assets and his digital money on his phone and loses access to this phone. Then the issuer can claw back the assets and tokens that were on this investor's phone. So I'm not going to create this token yet. I can also create my own asset. We call it the name. Let's call it a digital Qantas token, and we're going to issue that as a DQT. And we can define, so is there a maximum that an individual investor can hold in his wallet? The maximum amount, that is the number of or the amount of tokens that will be issued, how many decimals can be traded, and also here the clawback function. We can also add some optional data, so a URL to the validator or the company that holds the assets in custody, and for example a link to the Qantas website, and this information is stored on the blockchain, and therefore immutable. I can quickly show you how that works. If I go back to, let's say, the Qantas share. Oh, apologize, to my portfolio, and have a look at the Qantas share, and I want to know something about the asset. I can click on it, and in this case we will get redirected to the Qantas website. That brings me to my last point on my bullet list. If you would like to have further information about what we do on asset tokenization, feel free to visit our website and read about the asset tokenization, but also about the other services that we offer. There are quite some interesting publications on our website about our developments with our e-money license, or how we think that you could handle tainted cryptocurrencies. So thank you very much for taking the time to watch the demo. Over to you, Mark.
Okay, thank you very much. So, as I said earlier, we were founded in 2015, and since then we have done quite a number of public blockchain projects, and these include projects with some of the front runners in the blockchain industry, such as, for example, Bitcoin Suisse, Bankfreak, and also Quickbit. Then we also have a large number of enterprise blockchain projects, and this is often with larger corporates such as Airbus, Porsche, and BASF. And currently we are working on two groundbreaking tokenization projects. One is together with the Algorand Foundation, and another one is with Neo Finance Group. And with Algorand, we are building a platform that will enable tokenized bonds to be directly issued and traded for e-money. And thereby we provide SMEs in Europe with easier access to capital markets. And then with Neo, we have recently successfully completed a proof of concept for the digital issuance, safekeeping, custody, and also the subsequent trading of securities on a distributed ledger. And our team consists of 19 team players from 8 different nationalities. And currently, again, almost all of us work from home, but we have a headquarters in Utrecht in the Netherlands. And our team is highly experienced, and we are very confident that we can create and also execute the solution that you are looking for. And for today, that's it. We hope that this session has really helped you to understand what blockchain technology and asset tokenization, but also Qantas in general, can do for you and for your business. And if you have any questions, I will now try to allow you to unmute yourself so we can maybe get a little bit of a dialogue going.
Any questions?
Henri, there was already one in the chat. Maybe you can get to that in the meantime.
Oh, there's a long chat. It's about voting. There is no voting in this demo, but we are currently working with one of our clients on enabling voting. So that is in progress, and the annual report, tax report, is not part of our service offering. That is the issuer's responsibility. So we do not provide legal or tax advice. And resolution of conflict, I think that is something that is a special case, and that's currently also not supported. Okay, so I think that with the voting, we support it with our technology, but it's not part of this demo.
Does anybody else have any questions? You should now be able to unmute yourself as well. Then I think that's it for now. Henri, what do you think?
Okay, then, thank you very much. And if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to Mark and me also after the session. Our email addresses and LinkedIn links are on the screen. And I would say enjoy the Christmas holidays and stay safe, stay well. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Everyone.
Take care. Thank you. Merry Christmas. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Merry Christmas. Bye-bye.